This tutorial is about the spin tool in Blender. It's more useful than I realized when I started using Blender. Stay to the end and I'll show you a related tool that's also handy. Let's go. The spin tool extrudes geometry and spins it around a pivot point, creating as many different segments along the way as we tell it to. Like many things in Blender, there are more than one way for how to use the spin tool. I'll show you two methods. The fundamental things to know with the spin tool are, 1. The default pivot point is the 3D cursor. That's what the geometry will spin around. 2. The direction of the pivot is based on the current angle we are viewing from in the 3D viewport. That's not the camera view. For it to work properly, we generally want to be in an orthographic view. Orthographic views are specific views looking directly from the front, back, side, top, or bottom of a scene, and perspective is turned off in these views. Shortcuts for orthographic views are found on the number pad on our keyboard. 1 is front view, 3 is side view, 7 is top view, and pressing Ctrl plus any of these numbers flips the direction of the view. Choose the orthographic view we want to see the profile of the spin from. In this case, I want the top of this object to spin to the right from this front view. Select the geometry we want to have spin. I recommend placing the 3D cursor in the general area of where you want the geometry to spin around. You'll see why in a second. Here's the first method of using the spin tool. In edit mode, and with the geometry we want to spin selected, use the shortcut Alt-E to bring up the extrude menu. At the bottom, choose spin. We get this at first, which is not what I was going for. To fine-tune this, we open the operator panel at the bottom left corner of the viewport. Let's look at our options and let's go down to the angle setting first. The spin defaults to a full 360-degree angle, which sometimes is what we want. In this case, I want the spin to turn 90 degrees, so I'll change this to 90. If we wanted it to go the other direction, we would put negative 90 here. The step setting at the top is how many extrusions are used to make this spin. A higher number will make a smoother turn, but adds more geometry. It just depends how much geometry we want for what we're trying to accomplish. If we check this Use Duplicates box, we get the extrusions, but without them being connected to each other. The geometry is just duplicated and moved along the path. That's not what I want here. Now the fine tuning. Here we have two sets of adjustments we can make. The top set are 3D coordinates for the location of the pivot point for the spin. Remember, this starts at the location of our 3D cursor, but we can adjust it. But notice no matter how we pivot this, the final piece of geometry will have rotated the 90 degrees specified in the angle setting. The second set of adjustments is for the axis. This is by default based on our current viewport view, but it can be adjusted. Each axis has a value from negative 1 to 1. Notice the spin entirely affected just one axis and the other two are 0. If we want to spin on just one axis and had the correct orthographic view to begin with, we shouldn't have to change any of these. What these are for is if we want the spin to occur on more than one axis. If we wanted it to twist as it turns, we can play around with the settings here. I'll point out this auto merge checkbox, which you probably want to leave checked. What it does is not what I thought it did originally. If you create a full 360-degree spin, this merges the two ends together. With it unchecked, you end up with overlapping and unconnected geometry at the ends. So what is the other way to use the spin tool in Blender? It's using the actual spin tool found in the tool panel. The tool panel is on the left and toggles open and closed with the shortcut T. Down here, the tools icons look like a sliced up pie. In edit mode, select the geometry we want to spin. With this tool, your view is not really important. When we select the tool, we get some controls on the top. Here is where we input how many segments or steps we want in the spin and on which axis we want it to spin. We also get these gizmos. Yes, that's actually what they're called. They're little handles with which we can drag our spin out. Every time we do, it creates a new spin, and honestly, I think it gets kind of confusing. But the benefit is we don't need to be in a specific view, and we can see how the spin looks from different angles. I promised that if you hung around, I'd show you a tool that's related to the spin tool in Blender, and that's the extrude repeat operation. Here's how it works. Select a part of the mesh, press Alt-E, and this time choose extrude repeat, and open the operator panel at the bottom left. Extrude repeat does what it sounds like. It creates repeated extrusions in a given direction. We control the number of extrusions. These are called steps. The offset is how far in each direction the mesh is extruded. And between these two things, we have a lot of control over how we extrude something linearly. This is basically like the spin tool, but without the spinning. Check out my inexpensive Brandonville building packs on Blender Market, and I would love to have you as a subscriber on this channel. Thank you and stay creative.